funded the AES program, NASA, called Corporate Software. Slide on what this program is, so I'm just going to kind of verbalize. I think it was back in FY15 that the agency to recognize what Goddard did with Corporate Software and recognize that it could really be an agency asset. They knew that there were others using it as grassroots. After that project, headquarters decided to Corporate Software project with focus, at least as it was conceived, the focus was going to be on bringing it into the realm of human spacecraft, extending the usability across centers, trying to maybe embellish the product line, that sort of thing. So I think all the projects, I mean, I know this has been kind of grassroots, and the work that has been CSS has been really primarily projects that needed it. This one is actually funding it to a small degree, mind you, to kind of at an agency level across. So I'm going to summarize all the work that has been done in FY13 through 15. I'm going to do an FY16, and then just briefly just talk about outside of this AES. What processing the other at JSC. And I'm kind of going to whip through this thing. It's going to be sort of like a fire hose. And if some interest somebody, just get with me offline. So I'm just going to do kind of one page on each effort. You know, a very long effort. But I'll do a page on it, and then you can ask questions to me far later. Okay, so this is the listing of us in FY 13, 14, next slide will be 15. Investigate core software on a partitioned operating system. A lot of the human rated Orion using partition system. We put the suit on what would be the Boeing 787 platform. CSS in a highly redundant architecture, which is a little bit different than it was probably originally intended. So these are the kind of we discussed within Trix. That's the simulation environment. I'll go on each one of these individually once in a while. We work with SVM, which would enable distributed CSS, work on a reusable search certification test. Did a class A search the CSS integrity operating system on the Orion primary flight platform. So I know I'm using it on that platform right now, but it's available. So for us in the room, there, you should run a CSS partition on that primary. Monitoring tool, system. Development. All of this has been product line work going on with special folks just trying to call support for people. So there's always this level of product line going on. We built a couple of BDD, grant dictionary tools, like get another tool, and trying to maintain this level of education outreach. In F-team, the main thing we did is did a class A search for Orion, not really just for Orion, and on VX works for the Leon. The reason the program agreed to fund this is because they don't believe it's just for Orion that we could buy it, and they'll probably end up using at least the test of spacesuits and the half mission. So for another future class A work, we saw this as something that could be used. Down the road. And so we've actually done quite a bit of integration with other AES projects this year, primarily BNN, to link up a whole bunch of projects with habitation, integration, or technology development to the and This year, we prototyped the Orion backup on the Leon 3 just to do some performance analysis. It's pretty interesting. We developed a CI and TO app. If you're familiar with what you get on SourceForge, there's the lab app that comes. We a focused effort on developing generic versions of this that can be deployed for the whole community that are reconfigurable. So that's going to be to put back in the product line. We did some more. We have we finished one generic tool and started developing another one. Patient outreach, and asynchronous multi-core is something that we're working on in earnest this coming year. I just mentioned I have one slide, and mostly they're just pictures. So if you've never seen 787, if you've flown 787 aircraft, this is what the flight computer looks like. And Integrity OS running a partitioned architecture, we put that and ran it. And that doing a Class A for the Orion on the primary, because the Orion Foy hardware was based on the product, this is Boeing 787. Time on, I think this from the get-go is synchronization and voting. I don't know if I want to call it a plug-in or some app to the CFS framework to enable synchronization and voting between any number of processors. A lot of you can add how many ever you want, but what we have with this plugin that's very configurable, you can say you can run it on multiple, like this shows four processors voting. There's a Raspberry Pi, RPC, F0. And this is the display here. And there's an AMD. Anyway, there's computers both different operating systems. That, which is very different than some of these that are homogeneous voting systems. These are, I think, 750s. These are the four BeagleBones that Matt mentioned. We have what the display. And we try with the CFS philosophy on this, where it's highly configurable. So what you can do is you can configure what methodology you want. You want to have a majority, you want to have some master, you want to average it. You can do it on a data point by data point basis. So very flexible system, and what you're voting how and when even. So we have the most recent thing that we've done. The TPC guy mentioned it a little bit. Is we put the system on this is a time triggered gigabit network. Zeros, I think, for the same processor. But this was really this year because prior to this, very quick internal network for the voting, we were voting really slow, like at 1 hertz or 10 hertz or something like that. But we have this system set up with a time trigger, we're going to really ramp and do it at speeds that would be usable entry or asset entry type application. So that's on our voting. And this we haven't put back in the product line yet. What the path forward is, this is probably a very limited intro. I don't know how many people do level. Besides JS, I don't know, but that works available somehow. I think we did, as was mentioned earlier, we have this. In JSC, we typically use a simulation environment called Trix. The interesting thing that we did with it is we deployed it and said that within Trix. So it's one executable. So the simulation environment is the master, and it controls the clock, and it controls the schedule. But complex software it does, they don't know the difference that they're running in the SIM or they're not running in the SIM. So making this embedded product was something that we undertook. We did it by taking out the scheduler. We wrote a trick scheduler. So the a FATO trigger controls all the rest of the CSS app. So this allows pause, stop, fast forward, rewind, do all kinds of things in a simulation environment. Peek and poke. I also run this where the core is separate over UDP, like other apps do that. This is a picture of how when we first implemented this in Morpheus, this is a trick. But this is what you would get for the full flight software output. So it's running like running on the real deal. We took some try and beef up the SDN app to get a distribution of core flight software running. We did a demo of that. I think an FY410, multiple CPUs, all the data, and then a ground. Maybe a handheld to do some over wireless, so maybe some guys out today, and he's got some instruments, and if you just all talk about the software bus to each other. There's another end of this, so I guess that's we're anxious to get that one and start working with it. And I'll show you that shows you why. That we're involving some of the people involved in the Class A work on the Orionary system. So this is just sort of a verification and validation. We did on a Simic platform, and then we went to the Orion facility with hardware to do our validation. Okay, developed the performance monitor. I believe this is available in the open source release that we've actually used quite a bit, just some sample screenshots from it. But it comes with the hook to add, when tasks are inspected. And this tool basically just reads those log files and just the data in a lot of different cool ways, timing. A flow of execution from task to task, using charts, and it has a lot of maintaining that. If we and a dictionary tool, I think it's a general theme. How do you manage your telemetry and command list? How do you generate rec files and files, so we had a tool to do that. This is a one page on the education outreach work. Provided much more information on that today, but I think the point we wanted to do was have a cheap fun day of showing the universal in core flight software, how to use a simulation and write all of your stuff and then deploy it on hardware. At least how we do it is like not enough hardware to go around. Okay, I got to find more. Okay, this is the class. Let me see. Picture. This is our class A. The three layers CFE, the VL, the Leon 3. Part of this, but what we also did with all these tests. We have API tests, and then we added a search test to do full coverage testing. So those are all the tests that you get along with it. And then we have vertical validation tests. So everything is tested in there because they work together, and that's a test that does that. So these numbers 1 through 9 are where I consider the products that we delivered, and I just wanted to show people the tests. So the tests are like 56,000 lines. But I hope to continue on with every release of the people get this, and they have this full set of tests, and they can be confident using it. Class A, B, This is a picture of all the projects that have been told to use CFS or try to use CFS did. Didn't have anything hardly to do with it, and these guys took off. But everybody's talking, oh, these are multiple centers created by Glenn, JFC, Marshall, and Ames. They're sitting over SBN. Generally have this work is a multi effort. This is the exploration augmentation model. This is the power system. The system. This is a cascade distiller. That's a water system. Anyway, a lot of these systems, and this work will continue this year. They rely on all of this intercenter communication and inter. Yeah, and made it work. So one page from Jeremy is the lead for the ASO project. He adopted just about all of his vehicle systems to CFS bubbles this year, and those are big gaps. And for each of these systems, cascade filler, the amp, it was teaching on battery system. That example of this is a picture proof of concept. I think the interesting thing to say, we ported the EST1 Orion flight code CFS3, see what do, and it ran, but it ran really slow, like not so if Rob's here, it
didn't. Although that was movement of data out the NIC.
Yeah, it was data. Well, there's a pie chart with the performance. There's PO and CI apps we built. So this is pretty much finished this year, but we're still going to maintain it into next year. But it was a really layered approach to the PO and CI apps that are modeled against the OSI model, and very flexible and configurable. So you can add new protocols as you want, and there's a user's guide and the API interface, which actually we're sharing with Orion. Okay. Metadata dictionary tool, you have another one. Same guy that did the Java performance monitor, and he took a approach where this should be configurable, and you can, but if you need different products taken out of it, you write scripts that can be plug-ins. So he made such that new users can plug in additions without having to do a product. And I'm just working on this year, but really we're doing it on some projects and going to get some that we use out of it. We also have another ground tool with the modeling group of people that did that have thing. They felt like they needed a tool, so they built it based on system apps. So this is a ML tool that generates and takes an effect. We have a list that I keep of the platforms. A lot of the ones on the right is a lot of what we're doing at JFC. So keys and OS is here and there. If anyone's interested in that, we'll publish. Here. So I have been doing these things. Continuing some product line work. AES that chart to integrate all those other AES projects across the network for the HAB work. So we're working on getting the CV up on a Leon 4 and a Tylera 36 this year. We want to do a symmetric. I think leading that he started with the work from APO a couple of years ago. We're starting with that and moving with it. APO, we're going to keep the voting. Actually going to buy it to AA2, which is from Orion. I asked them to abort too. With we're going to work out, so got some funding to do some performance as well as develop a proficient version of them. I know that works well with John to do that together. Still SDN, out and deploy it with all the people using it with the command data dictionary tool, and I want to finish that course. A couple of pictures. We did the Proton multi-core. I think he started with John, a couple of guy working on the dual core Proton. Then we want to go to the plot and then the compiler. And one because I think, well, even about we're gonna do voting on the cores and then at the autonomy app on some of the other cores, and I think that could be really. People watching that. I'm in that diagram about connecting all those tab systems this year. And here's my this will be a slide, but this is projects going on at JSC. Some of these are PATH, Morpheus, all those VFS projects, MMSEV, we had it down at Capital. I think that was canceled. Some of these AES projects and all these others, ASO, Autonomous System Operations, CPN, CCS, AMP, these are AES projects using CFS. In addition, these are flight projects that are under development right now. We have one for the DOD payload office. I think these are that TO and CI.
Okay.
There's TR. Oh, okay. So it's not this year. Okay. I have the Orion BPU, which runs the backup, and you've heard about that. Also, on it's called the camera controller, not the video processor, but it's on the board Orion that's running CFS. And then you play experiment. I'm not going to do these on my bubble chart.
How different is the Class A version from the mainline version? And is there anything that shouldn't become the mainline version?
Our plans are for it to become the mainline version. The differences are slight in terms of mostly they're just the same rules that. Problem. So, yeah, an effort underway now to merge in what we have with Class A with the current trunk. I think the big addition we have with the Class A work is really the test. Because you have these comprehensive tests as well as the API test and the vertical test. So, if the tests are maintained along with the, I think it's a solid product for anybody.
Changes based on those.
Cost in
in the appropriate places for your APIs. That's code,
right?
But it solves compilation issues and it passes the middle of the room. So those are folded in, but they don't mean nothing changes except for at compile.
Yeah, the API.
No, it's in constant file.
Oh, right. Along with the changes that have been going on since we branched it off.
Another comment? Emergent.